one, we're going to do the sequencing of this IFC controlled furnace. Now, as I've said in the earlier video, this is way different of sequencing because you can't follow the wires. They all go to the board. The board makes the decisions on what to do. So what they do with these things is they put blinky lights on them. Otherwise, you're really not going to know. If you come out and it's shut off, you're not going to know why. So you're going to have some lights on here to tell you where to look. And it doesn't necessarily tell you the problem, but it tells you where to look. Okay, so let's go over these lights right quick. Flashing slow simply means normal, no call for heat. That means the power's there and it's ready for a call for heat. Flashing fast means normal with a call for heat. So we're actually calling for heat. Continuous on means you replace control. Okay, what that means is, it means the control's dead, obviously. But these things test themselves every second or so. So they run a circuit through it. So it's failed to run the circuit through it. And instead of flashing slow, like saying, yep, we're fine. It's continuous on, so it's not, it's somewhere the sequence is stopped, so it just stays on. Continuous off, that's, well, check power. It's 24 volt controlled, so it doesn't mean power to the furnace isn't there, although it certainly could be. It means you don't have 24 volt power. Okay, the different flashes for different codes. Two flashes means the system is locked out, no flame. That means this thing is tried three times to light. And it has not lit, and so it locked out. These will usually start again in about an hour and try again. And they'll run three times again. So there could be, for whatever reason, it either doesn't have gas to it, something's broken, flame sensor isn't sensing flame, igniter's not lighting, something like that. Three flashes is a pressure switch problem. It's not telling you the pressure switch has failed. It's telling you it's a pressure switch problem. The inducer didn't come up to speed. Maybe didn't come on at all. Maybe you got a blockage in the vent. All those things could cause a pressure switch problem. Four flashes, thermal protection open. Okay. What we've got there is we've got two limit switches on this thing, and those limit switches have to work, but they have to be closed, or this thing's not going to go any farther. Five flashes, flame sense with gas valve. Well, I've never had this happen, but I suppose if a gas valve stuck on mechanically or something like that, I mean, it's going to give you five flashes, but you're going to know something's wrong anyway because the furnace won't shut off. Anyway, those are the flashes on. This is an older furnace. This thing's about 20 years old, 25 maybe. And it was fairly simple. They didn't have a lot of complex flashes on these. But let's go over some of the parts that are on this thing. Okay, here's the vent motor here. Here's the igniter here. That's a hot surface igniter. 24 volt transformer is here. We've got the limit switch for the vent motor right there. We have a first stage pressure switch, both high temperature limits. One's a rollout, one is in the airflow. Second stage pressure switch. And this, unit uses an ECM motor, and that's a controller for the ECM. Okay, so let's go through a quick sequence of operation of this thing. If we have flash fast flashing, then as soon as that comes on, the pressure switch, the board's going to check the pressure switch and say, is this pressure switch open or closed? If it's closed, it won't come on. That's safety. If it's open, inducer comes on, increases the pressure. the pressure switch closes. Now this does two things. One, it feeds back into the board and tells the board that the pressure's okay and we're ready to go. The other wire here goes over to the limit switches and checks to see if they are closed. If the board sees that these switches are closed, then it continues. So both pressure switch and limit switches have to be closed for this to continue with the sequence. At that point, it's going to light up the igniter. Here's the igniter right there. Igniter is going to warm. There'll be a trial for ignition, which means a gas valve down here is going to open. We've got the common right here coming over the gas valve, and we've got the low fire right here. Okay, it's going to turn on the low fire and the gas valve, and if the flame lights, then the flame sensor is going to say, okay, we can continue to run. Then there's a time period starts, and it's about, I think it's 30 seconds, and the ECM fan control goes into the low heat speed, and the fan starts. Okay, if we go to second stage, well, we've got a second stage pressure switch here. So what's going to happen is W2 is going to be energized down here at the terminal board. That's going to tell the board we want second stage heat. So the vent motor is going to go up to high speed. And this pressure switch, this second pressure switch here for second stage, is going to close. And the power is going to go to the high fire of the gas valve. And the gas valve is going to go to high fire. Well, you notice there's a second wire here. That goes back to the board and tells the fan motor to go to the second stage heat, which is a higher speed. And there's a delay on that. There's, God, I thought it was 60 seconds, but I'm not sure on that. Anyway, there we have fired this thing up. First stage, second stage, and everything has worked. If any of these flashes come on, you're going to start looking in that area for what the problem is. System lockout, of course, no flame. That means hot surface igniter didn't come on, flame sense didn't flame sense flame. Gas valve didn't come on, no gas is available, something like that. And of course, your thermal protection, that's right here. These are not going to let this furnace start. In fact, they're going to leave the fan motor on. The fan motor will start if you have the thermal protection open. And I don't know what's going to happen with the flame sense with the gas valve off. Anyway, that's it on that one. I hope it makes some sense.